Hello, and thank you for clicking on this video. Today we're going to talk about the engulfing pattern. And if you ever wondered what is the success rate of this thing, whether you should be trading this engulfing Japanese candlestick pattern at all, and any similar question to that, you better stick with this video till the end because I have some interesting things to show you. What we're going to do is pretty much go over multiple asset classes, see how this pattern is performing, different time frames as well we're going to check out, and basically make some kind of general conclusion here whether it is worth trading the engulfing pattern at all or not. So the very first thing we're going to do is define what exactly are we going to be trading with this model, because there are different variations that you can find online or I guess in the books, but basically what we are going to stick with today in this video and how the algorithm was coded and developed basically is based on this definition. So you have the first candle. Okay, we're talking about the bullish one, bullish engulfing at the moment. What happens is you have a red candle, which means the price opens here and closes here, and you have a red candle, right? Then you have the opening of the next candle below the close, and you have the closing of the green candle above the open. In other words, the body of the most recent candle is engulfing the body of the previous candle, right? This is the definition that we're going to use, and this is the pattern that we're going to use based on that. Now, a bit more research. This time we're looking at Investopedia, shows that, again, we have the same definition. So I've decided to go with this one. And if you believe this is not how engulfing pattern should be defined, please comment below. It would be interesting to see what are your sources, why do you believe so, etc. And maybe we can make another video with different kind of definition of this pattern. Anyway, so let's go and check out the results. By the way, one thing before we begin, if for some reason you would like to get your hands on this robot, the expert advisor that I've created to do this all this research, leave your comment below, sorry, not comment, leave your email below and I'm going to send it to you. It's absolutely no problem. So what we're going to do is deposit 5K with leverage of 1 to 100 for each and every asset that we're going to be testing. The risk size will be the minimum lot size for the given asset, okay? Whatever this asset might be. For this specific analysis, as you can see in the sheet, we're going to be doing Forex. We're going to be trading both the bullish and the bearish engulfing, and we're going to be doing it on the daily time frame. The modeling quality is 1 minute open, high, low, close, and there is no delay for this specific test. It's been tested from 2018 up until December 2021. And what we're going to do, and below you will see that, is that we're going to start playing with the risk reward ratio. I will start slowly increasing that to see what kind of results we are getting. Also, in this specific video, there is no filter applied, meaning if we see the pattern as it was described in the beginning of the video, a trade will be opened, all right? There is no extra filter. And by the way, this is a perfect time to mention that if you're trading these patterns and you'll see the conclusions that we're going to draw at the end, but if you're trading this pattern purely based on the pattern itself without any extra strategies or filters or whatever, right? Those are the results that you can expect. If you're going to be doing something different, like I don't know, applying divergences, applying support resistances, whatever it is, any type of filter, these results could drastically change. And in the next video, we're going to cover one simple filter. Okay, applying this simple filter, and you'll see how the results will change. But let's start step by step, and we'll get there. So, as I said, starting with the Forex pairs, what we can see is that I'm not going to count them, but this is the daily chart. We have probably 60, 40, 70, 30 ratio of losers versus profitable pairs, right? And this is daily chart. We're not even talking about 4 hour, 1 hour, 15 minutes or anything like that. Meaning that majority of the trading pairs, if you're not applying anything, right, any kind of filter, will be losing. And this is a risk-reward ratio of 1-to-1, meaning if you're risking 100 pips, you will be looking to gain 100 pips. So I'm not really thrilled about these results, but this is what the backtest is showing. We can also see that, and you can write those down and later on try to figure out the correlation between which pairs are actually working better, which pairs are working worse with this specific engulfing pattern. But this is what we see, okay? Moving forward, increasing the risk-reward ratio to 1-to-2. I don't think we have any specific increase. Maybe a few more pairs are actually reaching the break-even point or slightly above. But in general, the results are, again, not that impressive. I mean, if this is something which people are writing in the books, and again, I'm not saying here that we're using the strategy or anything. It's simple engulfing pattern, raw material, right? It's not that impressive. Going down, and we're looking at 1-to-3. Again, you're going to notice that and that actually makes sense. More pairs are starting to lose money because now you're asking for 10 pips or 100 pips, and then you're asking for 3 times more in terms of target, right? So it makes sense for more trades to be losing ones, but we can also see that the profit starts to increase. So at the top here, we're reaching approximately 100 bucks. Here we're reaching 90 bucks. And also look at the profit factor, what's happening with the profit factor, 178, 278, et cetera, starting to increase, right? As opposed to here, where we are not even able to cross above the 2. So it starts to become interesting what is actually happening when you increase the risk-reward ratio. It starts to make more sense in terms of the profits. And we continue down, going for 1-to-4. Here we still see probably increasing some, but we start to stall, meaning that the number 3 profit factor is not even in the list anymore. But on the other hand, if you take a look at the profits start to increase again. Okay, we see dollar cut is able to push to approximately 150. Now, one thing I forgot to mention in the beginning is the number of total trades. And in general, if you're going to be making any conclusion, statistical conclusion, you want to have as much data as possible. In this case, time is decent, I would say, from 2018, the beginning, the start of 2019, till the end of 2021. But you can see how very few trades we can expect if we're trading on daily chart. So this is also something to pay attention to. The number of samples we have here is not significant. And then we're moving forward. This is the last one, by the way. I'm not going above more than 1-to-5. We can see that the profit is again increasing slightly. The risk reward, the profit factor remains above 2 for the top 4, right? And you will notice that the same pairs would start appearing again and again and again. And this is something interesting, but more about that at the end. So this is how it looks when it comes to Forex pairs trading both bearish and bullish engulfings on the daily chart for the last few years. Now let's go ahead and check out the same thing, but on the 4-hour chart. Now, as you can see here, we're switching to H4, same requirement, sell, same idea, everything is the same, just the time frame is different. Now, the sample size starts to increase now. And what else we can say is that the win versus loss size or ratio is also drastically changing. So now we have probably 85-90% of the pairs losing money as opposed to just a few of them making money, all right? So you can see how much this engulfing pattern means on the different time frames. And as usually people say, and I think this theory is proved here, the higher time frames are usually more reliable. What exactly is the reason for that? I can't really say, all right? No one can be sure. We have some ideas what might be causing it, but what is it at the end of the day? No one can say, right? Now let's increase the risk reward ratio to 1:2. Profit factor again stays around the same. I don't think we're seeing a drastic increase of winning versus the losing ratio here. Maybe just slight improvement of the actual profit, money-wise, nothing else. Then we're going to 1:3, and here we start to see that probably a few more pairs were included as profitable ones, which means increasing the risk-reward ratio actually makes sense. The profit factor, however, is not really moving anywhere. It's not going anywhere. And when it comes to money-wise, what's happening, profit 73 here as the maximum. Here we have 76. Okay, euro ruble, and here we have euro Aussie. So I wouldn't say this is that good, right? Going to 1:4 risk reward ratio, again, this stop versus profit is not changing that much. Profit factor is not changing that much, but we can see that still some pairs will be able to make money after X number of trades. So when it comes to Forex, here is the 1:5, and now we have some beautiful profits compared to the previous ones. When it comes to FX pairs alone, I think it makes a lot of sense to go ahead and approach the pairs which are consistently making money, all right? And this is going to be probably your job if you want to be using this EA on your own. Check out which pairs are consistently making money across the different time frames, across the different risk-reward ratios. Once you figure out the list of 2, 3, 4, 5, put them on the charts, with their own settings, and probably this is going to be the way to approach it. At least this is how I see it, right? And one more thing, once again, the sample size when it comes to the 4-hour chart is much higher, so this statistical analysis here on the H4 is much more reliable than the daily chart. I just wanted to make sure that we're going and comparing the same time frame set, or should we say time range set, between the daily and the 4-hour chart. That's why I'm doing it like this. Now let's move on to the next asset class, which is crypto. Here we have just a few, right? I don't have that many in the broker, but I think this is more than enough to go ahead and make some kind of general conclusion. Now this time we're using 1K with leverage of 1:100, starting with the daily chart, same requirements, absolutely everything is the same, and we will be looking at the risk reward ratio. So what's happening here? this time we can see that most of these pairs will be actually making money. When it comes to the data sample, it's not that bad because we have data for most of them, actually all of them here, right? We can see we have trades, and those trades, the number of trades is more or less comparable to this one. If you want, you can go ahead and check it out. So what do we see here? Well, we see that the profit factor, of course, if it's above one, that means we have profit, and it makes sense to see everything above one here because we have only two losing ones. And this is actually fantastic news if you're trading crypto, okay? Then we move down. By the way, one thing I forgot to mention here is the drawdown. Okay, you have quite large drawdown, but of course, let's not forget we moved from 5,000 to 1,000 here. So this is also making some difference for us, right? Once to the profit margin starts to increase, right? Same amount of trades. Profit factor doesn't move that much. We still have the ones and the twos and the threes. Drawdown slightly increasing, but of course, when it comes to actually start and trading this thing, you will be playing with the risk reward. So, the risk management, this is not going to be vital. And again, one, two, three, this time we have three, right? It pretty much remains the same, but the profits are constantly increasing as we can expect. And now when it comes to one to four, only one losing pair, which is Ethereum Classic here versus the dollar. This is absolutely crazy, if you ask me. When we go to one to five, I believe the volatility says it's worth, and we can see some crazy numbers here because every single pair is actually delivering profits. Small one, big one, drawdown, etc. It doesn't matter. They are delivering profits. Go figure. Now the situation changes drastically when we go to the 4-hour chart. The results are absolutely terrible and we're looking at losses. This is why I did not include the 4-hour chart results here. But again, as I said, if you're interested and you would like to get the robot and play with it on your platform, drop your email below in the comment section and I'm going to send it to you. The third and the last one for this video, asset group that we're going to check out is metals. We have gold, copper, silver, and platinum here. And the results in general are absolutely terrible. Okay. We have occasionally the profitable sector, which one to five will be copper here, nothing here, nothing here, nothing. And when it comes to one to one, we have gold. But if this is about to be traded on a live account, I don't think these results would be even considered, and this pattern would be even considered for live trading here, okay? I think this is the final part. And then we go to the 4-hour chart, and again, the results are absolutely negative. So I didn't do the 1-hour chart and the 15-minute chart as I was intending to, because I saw that in general, once you drop below daily and 4-hour charts, things are absolutely not good, right? There is no need to waste your time. I'm just saying I will not even bother trying to create anything out of that, right, on the lower time frames. There must be something else that comes in play there in order to make the change and go from negative to positive. Now, in the next video, we're going to cover indices and probably one or two more asset classes. We'll see how long the video will take. But I wanted to cover indices in a separate video because they tend to have different behavior than Forex and crypto. Okay, their indices are trending in general, just like stocks, right? They usually go in one direction, which is up. While Forex and crypto we tend to see ranges, huge ranges that takes years to go from one to the other, from bottom to top, but in general, they're ranging. So this is why I wanted to switch. I am also going to add an extra condition there for the indices. And I think we can draw some interesting conclusions out of that. So as final words, what can we say? I think the numbers are speaking for themselves. You gotta be careful which pair are you going to be trading if you're trading it blindly. And if you're going to be trading it with some kind of extra strategy attached to the engulfing pattern, which is usually recommended, then you can actually put a comment below, guys, and we can try to do that as an algorithm and see how it performs. If you have any questions, you know where to find me. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.